Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you to the Italian Presidency of the Council of the EU and the Italian Interior Ministry for the invitation to address this conference. I'm sorry that I cannot be with you today, but I would like to voice my wholehearted support for the aim of this event. The Istanbul Convention, which came into effect on 1st August, is a very powerful instrument. It offers an entire region legally binding standards for the first time, containing a comprehensive framework for effective policies to combat all forms of violence against women, including domestic violence. At the same time, it anchors violence against women firmly in the human rights world. There are three areas of the Convention I believe to be particularly important that I would like to highlight here today. Firstly, the Istanbul Convention takes a multi-level approach to combating violence against women. This recognizes that cooperation is needed between actors at all levels, from governments through local authorities to national human rights bodies and, of course, civil society organizations. Secondly, the Convention focuses not just on cure, but also on prevention. This includes measures to empower women, but also, and that brings me to my third point, it involves men and boys as crucial to find ways forward. These and many other provisions in the Convention will help towards the change in mentality we need in order to fight violence against women effectively and lastingly. Because there's no doubt that violence against women is an enormous problem in our societies today. The EU Agency for Fundamental Rights published a report earlier this year that was based on a survey of 42,000 women throughout the European Union. And the results of this survey show that a large number of these women are suffering violence, violence at the hands of partners and of strangers, and at home and online. For example, an estimated 13 million women in the EU were victims of physical violence in the course of the 12 months prior to our survey. An estimated 1.5 million women in the EU were raped in the course of those 12 months. That's equivalent to the entire population of the city of Vienna, where I am today. A fifth of women between the age of 18 and 29 have experienced cyber harassment since the age of 15. These examples demonstrate what a long path we still have ahead of us, and therefore how necessary it is for the ratification process of the Istanbul Convention to continue. To measure changes in the situation, it is vital that national level surveys are carried out to detect trends over time. In this regard, I would like to compliment the Italian government on its current work to repeat its first ever national survey on violence against women from 2006. I hope that we can all meet in 5 or maybe 10 years' time to celebrate not only the Istanbul Convention, but also the improvements it has brought, an increase of gender equality in society and a decrease in cases of violence against women. I wish you all a successful conference.